Thank you. Thank you. It's so great to be here with you tonight. First time I ever got to share a stage with Jimmy was in Calaveras County. And he did that show with a broken leg. Big smile you ever saw. The next time I got to be on stage with him was probably 50 years later, and I opened for him in a stadium, a football stadium in Detroit. This is a song that Jimmy wrote for a friend of his who had been in the Spanish Civil War and had survived that and went on to go live in Europe, only to lose his family in World War II. Now, he knew this guy in Chicago, but in the last chapter of the song, he gave him a last chapter in his life of a life in the Caribbean, which is what he would want for himself, or what he would want for any of us, too. Level in my earphones is not in my ears. You know? There he is. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. No warm summer breezes, the French wines and cheese, but his ambition had been. Like splinters 4 or 5 years away. He went to England, played the piano, married an actress named Kim. They had a fine life, she was a good wife, and bore him a son named Jim. His baby, the bombs killed his lady, left him with only one eye. His body was battered, his whole room shattered, and all he could do was just cry. While the tears were falling, he was recalled. There were answers that he'd never found. Dishes the pines, drains his green label each day. He's writing his memoir, losing his hearing, but he don't care what most people say. Through 86 years of perpetual motion, If he likes you, he'll smile and he'll say, Jimmy, some of it's magic, some of it's tragic, but I had a good life all the way. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions.